بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، وصلي وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. الحافظ أبو الفرج ابن الجوزي died 597 after هجرية، disciplining the soul being a translation of his tib الروحاني. Every breath we take is taking us closer to death. The time we spend in this world is short. The time we are held in our graves is long. And the punishment for following our lowly desires is calamitous. Ibn Jawzi. Translated from the original Arabic by Ayman ibn Khalid. The biography of the author, Al-Hafiz Abu al-Faraj Abdurrahman ibn Jawzi, his name and lineage. He is Abu al-Faraj Jamaluddin Abdurrahman ibn Ali ibn Muhammad ibn Ali ibn Ubaid ibn Ubaidullah ibn al-Jawzi al-Qurayshi al-Tamimi al-Bakri from the family of Muhammad ibn Abu Bakr al-Siddiq al-Baghdadi al-Hanbali. His bad and upbringing. He was born in 509 or 510 after Hijrah. Upon reaching adolescence, his aunt took him to Ibn Nasir, from whom he learned a great deal. He came to love preaching while barely having reached the age of puberty, and from then he started to give sermons to the people. His father passed away when he was 3 years old, so his aunt took care of him. His relatives were copper merchants, so at times in hadith hearing he would write his name as Abdurrahman ibn Ali al-Safar, and the coppersmith. His first hadith hearing was in 1506 after Hijriya, and studied by Dahabi. While still very young, he became known as a religious person who could not socialize with anyone and would not eat from any food whose source was doubtful. He would only leave his house for prayer, and he would not play with others similar to his age. He was a person of very great determination, ambition, and experience of his life busy in seeking knowledge, preaching, and ordering his teachers. Al-Hafiz ibn al-Jawzi has already introduced his teachers in his book Mashaykhat ibn al-Jawzi, the scholars who taught ibn al-Jawzi, where he listed many of them. In the field of hadith, he benefited from accompanying Ibn Nasir in Quran and Adab Manas from Sibt al-Khiyat and ibn al-Jawalik. He was the last to narrate from Ad-Dinari and al-Mutawakkili. His student. Those who narrated from him include his son and companion. The great scholar Muhyiddin Yusuf was a teacher in the Institute of Al-Mustasim Billah. His oldest son Ali al-Nasik, his grandson the preacher Shams ad-Din Yusuf in Ibn al-Faghari al-Hanafi, the author of Miratu Zaman, the Mirror of Time. Al-Hafiz Abdul Ghani, Sheikh Muwafiquddin Ibn Qudama, Ibn al-Dubaydi, Ibn al-Najjar, and Adiyya. His children, his grandson Abu Muzfir, and the majority of those who are Urot, his wife said that he had 3 sons. The oldest of them, Abu Bakr Abdul Aziz, he became jurist in the school of Ahmad and took advantage from Abul Waqt. Ibn Nasir al-Anawi and a group of his father's teachers, he traveled the city of Mosul where he preached and held sermons there, for which he earned the people full acceptance. It is said that the family of Al-Zahra-Zuri used to be jealous of him, so they made someone poison and put in this leak, which caused him to die in Al-Mosul in 1554 AH during the lifetime of his father. Abul Qasim Badruddin Ali al-Nasik, Abu Muhammad Yusuf Muhyiddin, he was the most intelligent and youngest son, as he was born in 580 after Hijriya. He became a lover in preaching. He held sermons after his father, in which he expelled and by which he was looked up by his confreres. He then was appointed to control and supervise markets of Baghdad. After this, he was assigned to deliver the message of the caliphs to kings of the different regions, peculiarly to the Ayyubi family in the Sham region. He held the position of teacher in the Institute of Caliph Al-Mustam in 640 AH till he was killed in prison in 656 AH باي اين اي اي جزيره باي باي هولاكو هو كفايد بغداد اند ديسترويد ات از ذري سانس جمال الدين شرف الدين ان تاج الدين وكيل ودهيم هي اس او داد ميني وركس انكلودينج معادني ال ابريز في التفسير الكتاب العزيز ان المذهب الاحمد في مذهب احمد and like his brother Abul Qasim, he was Lutfu's son who honored his father and treated him well. His grandson mentioned that Ibn Jawzi had many daughters, Rabia, Sharaf, Al-Nisa, Zainab, Jahura, Sittul Ulama, Al-Sughra, and Sittul Ulama, Al-Kubra. His uniqueness as a preacher, excellent indeed are the words of Al-Hafiz Al-Dahabi, about him. He was a leading figure in reminding the people and had no equal. He would recite pleasant poetry, eloquent prose spontaneously. He spoke fine words and moving speech, which was abundant. There has never been anyone like him, not before him and not after him. He is the carrier of the flag of exhaustion in its various forms. He had a pleasant appearance, a good voice, and his talks had an impact on people's heart. His lifestyle, his style in general, was beautiful. He also said, I believe there will not be another one like him. Al-Hafiz Ibn Rajab said. So we conclude that his gatherings of exhaustion were one of a kind, and nobody had heard of anything like them. They were gatherings of great benefit where the heedless will be reminded, the ignorant will come to know, the sinners will repent, and the police will become Muslims. His works and effects. Sheikh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah said, in al-Ajwiba al-Misriya, Sheikh Abu Faraj excelled in many sciences and has many writings to his account. He will write on many topics. I accounted his works. I found them to be over 1,000 in number. Later, I found out about other works as well. Having mentioned some of his books, Adabi said, I don't know of a scholar who has written what this man has. The virtuous teacher Abdul Hamid Al-Ruji has written a book on his work, which was printed in Baghdad in 1967. And this piece has reached three titles. There are copies and copies that has been printed and put them in alphabetical order. Whoever wishes to know about these books should refer to this book, keeping in mind that many of the manuscripts mentioned therein by Al-Aluji have now been printed. He ordered approximately 300 books. Some of his printed works include Taqifuhum Abli Al-Athar fi Muqtasari As-Siyari Wal-Akhbar. Only a portion has been printed. Al-Atkiya wa Akbarahum printed. Manakib Umar ibn Abdulaziz printed. Rawhul Al-Awra printed. Shudur Al-Uqud fi Tariq Al-Uhud manuscript. Zad Al-Masir fi Al-Ilm Al-Tafsir printed. Al-Munaddam fi Tariq Al-Muluk Wal-Umam. Only 6 volumes have been printed. Al-Dahab Al-Masbuk في سير الملوك manuscript. الحمقى والمغفلين printed. الوفاء في فدائل المصطفى printed. مناكب عمر بن الخطاب printed. مناكب احمد بن حنبل printed. غريب الحديد printed. التحقيق only the first volume has been printed, and also a considerable number of works in other fields of knowledge. The books of Ibn Jawzi available in the English language are Ibn Jawzi's The Devil's Deception, edited trans Abu Amin Bilal Phillips, Al Hidayah Publishing and Distribution. Displaying the Soul, trans Ayman Ibn Khalid, Darus Sunnah Publishers, 1432, 2011. I am sincere counsel to the student of sacred knowledge. Trans Ayman ibn Khalid Darul Sunnah Publishers, 1432, 2020, 2011. The Disturber of the Heart. Trans Ayman ibn Khalid Darul Sunnah Publishers, 1432, 2011.
He's dead. Ibn Jawzi passed away on Friday the 12th of Ramadan in 1597.
after Hijriyan was buried next to the grave of Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal in the cemetery of Bab Harb.